kind of worried. And then my black paranoia kicked in, aka I feel like I fit the description. All right.
My exercise.
About to depart, about to get on this road. I gotta head to Shakopee. Let me turn this down right quick. That's how I keep my sanity in. Listening to comedy on the road. So I'm headed to Shakopee, Minnesota to pick up this load. Then I'm gonna take it to Illinois real quick. And yeah, I'm out here, baby. I'm out here, about to make this paper. Yeah, about to hit this road, hit y'all back in a minute when I get there. So I'm gonna hit y'all with a time lapse right about now. People have arrived. I'm out here in, what's this called? Shakopee, Minnesota? I don't know. Shakopee, Minnesota. And I gotta pick up this load. I guess a pipe. My dispatcher failed to tell me what I was picking up this time. I'm about to get her an ass about that. I should have asked her. That was my fault. Should have asked, yeah. Anyway, I'm taking this to Metamora, Illinois. It's about 463 miles. Not too bad. Making okay money on this load. And yeah, it's real lightweight, about 26,000 pounds, so that shouldn't be too problem, you know, in and out. But you know, when you get here, you gotta go check in at the office, and they give me a little ticket. I give it to the person working the forklift. Of course, I arrive right when they're taking breaks, so we shall see. But the dude said he was gonna unload that truck back here. I don't know if y'all can see it. See it over there? That truck back there. Yeah, that one right there. We're gonna unload that truck first because it has less on it. It's gonna be easy to take it off and on. And my truck's gonna take a little while to load. Other than that, I'll see y'all back in a minute. Yeah.
Okay.
Now this is one of those times, y'all gotta get a new helmet, new hat, but all beat up and messed up. But anyway, this is one of those times where you get bored on the truck. So you come back here, you watch them load the truck. One of two reasons, you bored. Second is, if you got a nice trailer you don't want to damage, you're gonna put eyes on your trailer while they're loading it at all times. And at the same time, you want to make sure you know how they load it. Just in case you get to your destination and they're puzzled on what's needed to get it off your trailer, because you don't want the damages. Because if you get damages, you're gonna be down. You gotta file, you know, claims against the company to get them to pay for it, because it's not your responsibility. Blase, blase, it ain't worth it. Alrighty, I'm out of here. Wasn't too bad. Some cheap product. I gotta look up what they Culvert is. Because that's the material I have. It's some sheets of metal that's curved in a semicircle and flanged down. Apparently it's supposed to go in a culvert and make it look pretty. Like that. I mean, some stuff like that. But you gotta know I'm talking to CB radio, it's annoying. But sometimes it's informative. But I'm about to hit the road, head to Illinois. It's about 6 hours, 53 minutes. It's gonna take me over 7 hours. I gotta take, you know, a few breaks. Go to the toilet, drop a few turds, you know, dookies, you know, that type of stuff. Food breaks, all that good stuff. So I'll see y'all when I get stuck.
All right. Here we go, baby. We're done.
Holding the...
Again, it's your boy D How. I've arrived in I don't know, let's check, see where I'm at. I'm currently on I-35 west, headed south. I'm still in Minnesota, looks like. I don't know the name of the city, but you know. It's right before you hit the border. I'm at a Casey's truck stop, and there was only one other black driver. He was getting gas and fuel, and he walked in. I walked in. I kept seeing, I'm not sure if I was being paranoid, probably was, but it seemed like, you know, a few of the cashiers were staring at him while all these other people were walking around. And then I see this. Flip the camera around so y'all can see it better now. See, there's a biker rally, I guess, about to start. I'm not really sure what it's for, but it's a lot of people on bikes. And yeah, very few people at the truck stop. Very few trucks, but a whole bunch of bikes. Now, what just happened to me was, I was going to throw my trash away. You know, we have the little trash bags in the truck, throw them away at the truck stop. It's getting full, right? And a police officer was pulling through in his car. There's two people in it, him and another police officer. And he looked at me, you know, like, hey. He didn't head nod or anything, or, you know, say hello. Just looked at me. And I didn't think anything of it, you know. Maybe recognized, I don't know. But then he did a second double take and lean forward, because he was, you know, pulling forward away from me, so he had to lean forward to look around his, what is it, B-pillar in the car, and he stared like deep into my eyes. I was kind of worried, and then my black paranoia kicked in, aka I feel like I fit the description. So I'm just recording this and documenting this. Matter of fact, let me go ahead and get the city so I can be sure when I pull off, don't no BS pop off. And my Casey General Store, 3424, located in Ellendale, Minnesota. Address, 3959 Minnesota 30, Ellendale, Minnesota 56026, and off of exit 26 on I-35. But yeah, this is, you know, the police officer interaction was kind of odd. The biker convention or whatever the rally they're about to do looks kind of cool, but I'm about to get my cell phone out of here right now. All right, people, I'm out of here. So I've arrived on site, ready to unload, and this guy just dropped something off the side of the truck. Yeah, I'm about to show you. So he's trying to pick up that load right here in the middle. That one fell off the side. A good thing to be alert while you're unloading. You never know what they're gonna say, who damaged what, whose responsibility is to pay for it to get fixed. And I saw it fall off in my mirror, so it will be he say, she say. point of that world, but okay. Last one just hanging on barely. Another thing I've learned is, man, this thing is horrible. Is that you got to stay alert when you're unloading, because the forklift drivers won't tell you when they're unloading. Say for example, I come, pull up, unstrap my load, sit in the truck and wait for them. They'll come sneak up on you. It's loud out here in the yard, so you can't hear everything. Start unloading you, so that's why you got to keep alerting your mirrors. And I saw him pull up on side of him. I didn't know what he was doing yet, but like he was preparing to unload, and he turned into it. I stepped out the truck to get it, and you saw what happened. He knocked one off.
Well, I know my life is out of luck,
it's been a long day, people. Finally reached my resting destination. That Walmart last night was straight, but it's time for showers and all that good stuff. I don't really need the fuel yet, but I need to find some oil. Oil's kind of low, check the coolant, air pressure, all that good stuff. Check the truck out. Hopefully my dispatcher finds me a load out of here today, and I can get to a TA truck stop and get some of this stuff worked on and head back to Houston. But I'm currently located at some off-the-wall truck stop. I don't know what it's called, but there's a Kenworth near here, too. I might go over there and see if they got some parts for my truck. And, replace
the skirt.
Yeah. I mean, old stuff. My bad.
Skirt.
I'm gonna hit y'all back in, I don't know how long. But, until then,